Hey guys, this is Matt Beck from freesaloneducation.com here with our new neighbor, Dan. And he moved in. We've been looking at this area. He's going to a wedding, so said let's do a makeover and let's film it. Why not? So what we're gonna do is focus on some key adjustments that I wanna make in his haircut. Right away, I looked at a few different things, so I wanna show you guys. If you look here, Dan has a pretty straight texture to his hair. That's what I noticed right away. And you can see, he said he's never really gotten a quality haircut before. So what you can see here is there's just some steps leading up to it. Because his hair is so straight, it sticks kind of straight out. So if you don't get the layers the same length, then you're gonna see those steps in the haircut. So what we're gonna do is definitely make that adjustment. I'm gonna be working clipper over comb. It's one of my favorite things to do. We're not gonna take it too tight. He is going to a wedding and he wants a classic tapered look. So we're gonna use our YS Park 209 comb. It's a little bit thicker, so it's easier with scissor or clipper over comb. So we're gonna work through his hair that way. I wanna start off with it kind of dry. The other thing you'll notice about Dan's hair is that he's loading it down with gel. And that's something that a lot of guys do because they either their hair's too long, it's a little bit out of control. So we wanna get Dan on a more regular schedule of getting a haircut so he doesn't have to mat it down with a lot of product. And show him some different product options that maybe won't make his hair so hard and crunchy, I guess we could say. So we're gonna get started. I'm gonna work my taper up. So I'm gonna grab my clippers. This is the clipper that I choose to use. It's a Wall Senior clipper. Works really well, and I also use the Auster Titan too. So we kind of flip back and forth, but for clipper over comb, this gets nice and tight. So as we work through, it'll work well for us. So I'm gonna go through, I'm gonna do the tight taper. You guys can watch that. I'm gonna speed it up just a little bit so we can get through it, and then I'll go on to the next step. So. As you can see, we're tapering this in, and one of the key things that I'm really focusing on is when I put the comb into the hair, I'm just beveling it out slightly. So we're building up a little bit of a graduation in this haircut. So that's what's really gonna build in that taper. So I wanna take it nice and close, but then tilt my comb out and run the clipper back. I'm also working diagonal back because that's gonna allow the weight flow to work back on his head. If I were to work horizontally, it's gonna remove that weight line straight across. And I want it to have a little bit of a flow back and build that taper up. So that line, the weight line should kind of fall a little bit lower towards the nape of the neck. So we're gonna keep working through, keep doing that, adjusting the lengths in his hair so he doesn't have those steps in his haircut. And then we'll go move to the top. Now, as I'm working through the back here, I keep working on that diagonal back. I don't want to switch to then go horizontal here because what that's going to do is then shift the weight line back up. I want to build in kind of a V shape to the weight, and then I'll remove a little bit more of that with the scissor. But in order to keep that nice and tight and build up that weight and keep the weight line going down, I don't want to switch over. So just make sure that that's a key thing that you want to focus on there as well. Just Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through with the trimmer. I wanna clean up all the edges, really get that shape in there of what I want his hairline to look like. And then I'll start working up the top. I like to try to keep nice and organized. We started on the right-hand side, worked our way down, keeping diagonal. Did the same thing, started on the left side, working diagonal back all the way down. Now I wanna clean up the hairline, then go into the top. It's really important to stay organized, because I think if you don't stay organized, that's how you end up with those steps in the haircut, because you just fly through it. That's typical of a salon that's just trying to get through their day, and that's not what we're trying to create. We want quality haircuts coming out, and the way that we're gonna do that is staying organized. So I'm gonna go in with my trimmer. I use a T trimmer. I like that because especially when I'm working around the ear area, the T trimmer can just glide along the ear to create that, well, just really to remove that length around the ear. Now, I don't want to square off the back, and this is a question that we've had quite a bit, is what do I do with this cowlick? You can see Dan has kind of a cowlick, a different growth pattern in the back. So what I want to do is kind of create my own to make it work for his hairline. So I take a look at a couple different things. You can see where it gets a little bit skinnier here, then it gets fuller. So really what I want to do is remove all of this stuff, take a little bit of that length that comes down here, take some of that off, and then round it up to the top. So I'm going to work through with my trimmer doing that, just kind of etching in the overall shape that I'm trying to create, maybe not the final shape to it. Just working my way around, and you can see how it starts to all start to come together pretty much right away. And I'll go through with the reverse end of my my trimmer, because that'll get the hair just a little bit closer to the skin so it doesn't grow out as quickly for him. We're gonna do the same thing on the opposite side, so I'll follow the hairline down. Now, where it starts to kind of, the density goes away right here and the growth pattern shifts and changes, I can go through and really even just freehand remove some of that weight. I'm not trying to comb it down or push it where it doesn't want to go in the first place, because all that's going to do is I'm going to lift it up, cut it, and now I'm going to have a hole right there, and that's not what I'm trying to do. So we'll go through, and now I really want to work this line for him. Alright, so now we're gonna wet down Dan's hair. I want to find out where I really want his part to live, and this will, it's a little bit easier to work on the top of the hair, on the longer part of the hair when it's wet. So alright, so we got Dan's hair combed back. It's nice and saturated. We're gonna work off of a parting, so he's got a right hand side part. A little deeper with it. You can really base this on the hairline. I like to, Dan does not have a receding hairline, so that's good. It's good for him, it's good news. So can go a little bit deeper with it. But again, just having that parting exactly where I want it helps with the rest of the haircut. So now I'm gonna go through, I'm gonna go back to my YS Park comb. I know it's a dark color and he's got dark hair, but I wanna use this to blend everything in together, and I'm gonna work scissor over comb for this part. So we're gonna work our way up the hairline. I don't wanna go too far, just comb it back down and then work again, slightly tilting that comb out, building up that slight bit of graduation in there, and you can see the weight line. So as I work down, we'll shoot it at this angle so we can hopefully see the buildup of weight in there. But I'm just dusting the ends off just to blend in that weight line, because I really do like having a nice solid weight line in there for this haircut. We're gonna work our way into the back, same thing. I'm just gonna dust over what I had already clipper over combed, just to kind of give a final check on it. Can also work up diagonal forward and just dust it, just to, a little cross checking. And then I'll work back, diagonal back, to really remove any weight that I need to. Same thing on this side, working up the head. But the biggest thing to notice is that I haven't shifted my comb angle at all. I'm working diagonal back all the time. If you can see this edge popping up over, it's really just all of his hair coming over to this side, so it's extra heavy right there. So what I wanna do is take right above the round of the head, or the parietal ridge, whatever you wanna call it, take that out. That's where the heaviness is, so I'm just gonna work on that instead of working on everything at once. And remove some of that bulk. This is to really get that big line out of there. And then I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna work my double zero Uragi scissor, texturizing scissor, because I wanna remove a little bit of extra bulk from Dan's hair. So if we can get, we can show it this way. A little better. If we can go in here, and I'm actually gonna dig the comb in a little bit deeper and just work that texturizing scissor through, removing some of that bulk, because he's still gonna have a line when the hair falls over, a weight line, but this is just taking out that extra bit of weight that would be coming through there. So now we comb his hair over. So you can see there's still weight there, but it's not as heavy as it was. Now Dan's got another little cowlick that kind of pushes this hair forward here. So I can just go in with my Uragi scissor for that as well and just remove a little bit of that excess weight, and it'll blend it up nice. And for the last little bit, I want to go through, I'm going to add a little texture to his hair because it's thicker. So I'm gonna go through and just do some point cutting, but also create a little bit of an angled line in there. So everything's gonna be over-directed up. And then I'm just gonna slightly change my finger angle. So instead of it being flat across, because that's just gonna build too many layers there, I wanna add a little bit of extra weight flopping over. So we're just gonna go through and do a point cut and connect the two sides here. That's going to give them that extra length to kind of flip over. Now everything's going to be over-directed to the previous. Very front, I want to change it up just a little bit because I do want to leave quite a bit of length in the front. I just want to remove a little bit of weight. So working diagonal forward from the part over to the hairline around the temple area. And that way it'll just give it a little kick up, but won't be so heavy in that area right along the temple. Now right in here, this pushes over. Dan's got another cowlick in here. So I'm gonna section the rest of his hair away. I just want to work on this cowlick that kind of tosses the hair over. So we're going to work scissor over comb. I'm going to let it shoot up because that's what it wants to do anyways. I don't want to take the rest of his hair this short. But that little bit, it's not going to hurt anything. And you can see how that kind of makes that disappear. It makes everything come together. And that's pretty much it. It's a nice classic tapered haircut. What I'm gonna do real quick is Dan's going to a wedding, so he can't have a beard, you know, that's out of control. So we're gonna go in and just clean that up and make it match into the haircut. And that's really what I wanna create. So let me show his, I like the length of his beard. There's nothing, you know, nothing wrong with that. So I want to go in and just take off the overgrown parts of it.
I just broke up with you, and now I'm sure I'll be the bad guy too. Although as we both know, that isn't true. Worse, you understand. I functioned well before I met you, and I don't know why I let you make me feel like such a feel empty and bland. And I was wrong to think we're better as a pair. I feel much better every day that you're not here. All the times I've gone so wrong, short and just a girl, all everything we've ever done, that's my love.
All right, so just a recap of what we've done. We took Dan's hair that had a little bit of steppiness to it, and we corrected that. We used diagonal back sections starting right at the temple area, working our way back to the nape of the neck on both sides. Just kept with that diagonal back sectioning, and that's, again, that's really important because that's gonna keep this weight right here. And I think that's an important part of this haircut and what really separates a lot of haircuts that I see out on the street when I think it's a good haircut or not so good haircut is that a lot of people bring this crown area too far up and it gets too short and you don't have that weight, so it doesn't balance the head shape that well. So just really work on diagonal back. That'll help you out there. we build up a nice taper to the hair, and then went in right here at his cowlick and just basically removed that, cut it about an inch long, and then allowed this longer hair to fall over it. So it'll just be easier for him to style. He won't have to deal with that. And then we cleaned up his beard, and now Dan's a new man. He's ready for the wedding. So I hope that this video helps you guys. Make sure you subscribe to us on YouTube. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And if you have any questions about anything that we've done here that we didn't cover, make sure you post them below in the comments. And thank you guys for watching. We'll see you on the next video.